So, question. You talked
Yeah.
about Donald Trump and Biden. Okay. Have you seen any change when it comes to US-Africa engagement, going from Trump's presidency to now Biden's presidency? Have you seen any shifts or the same old, same old?
I think it's too soon to make that claim. Look, when Jen Psaki gets up on at the lectern and tells us stories about what the president's saying or not saying, you got to take that for, what it is. It's a press spokesperson, and very little has been said about Africa so far. The president has committed to spending $4 billion for the COVAX facility to get develop vaccine to developing countries. Ironically, as a veteran, I can't get the vaccination, so I'm at the bottom of the list. So,
Wow.
but we're buying it for the rest of the world. Look, I have no objections to that, and also I'm not in a hurry to get the vaccine. So I'm making a facetious point, but it's a legitimate one. It's too soon to say. And honestly, this is the same foreign policy that George Bush gave us, that Barack Obama inherited, that he tweaked modestly, that went to Donald Trump, which didn't change despite all the hysteria. Oh my God, he hates Africa. He says asshole countries. Virtually nothing changed. The only change was that John Bolton announced 2 years into the administration, less than 2 years, that they had an Africa policy, one focused on trade and investment. That's a lovely sentiment. And they made a nice web page and they talk about this, they talk about that. But as I pointed out, hold your breath. Let's wait and see what happens. And not much has happened. So this is pretty much, in my view, in the aggregate, the same foreign policy. I mean, what people don't understand is that the U.S. government is nearly well, now it's more with all these stimulus packages, but a $5 trillion a year operation. $5 trillion a year. You don't stop programs like that. So for instance, the president's emergency program for AIDS relief, emergency, which of course created in 2003, 18 years ago, is still the president's emergency program for AIDS relief. We're still spending 30, $40 billion. It's a lot of money. And I'm not objecting to it because PEPFAR has been a brilliant program. It's had a massive and wonderful effect on Africa, particularly Southern Africa. It's made a huge impact. It's saved lives. It's helped alter behavior. It's changed culture, and it's been for the benefit by and large. But you really can't call it the president's emergency program. An emergency doesn't last 18 years. I mean, Mount Vesuvius doesn't explode for 18 years outside of Pompeii or Naples. It only does it for a few days or weeks, and then it's all over, and you move on. So my point is that that's still around by or not by Obama's Power Africa still around. These things, some come and go. They usually get renamed. And like for instance, a lot of the money we were spending on security assistance and peace negotiation, things like that, got rebranded and part of the Security Governance Initiative, which was an Obama era thing, which came with no funding. So they just took it from other places. And by the way, to be fair, PEPFAR, when it was created, took basically all the HIV spending in all the federal agencies and put it under PEPFAR. Now they added a lot of funding later on, almost immediately, but initially, just all the programs that existed, including the Department of Defense programs, were lumped under PEPFAR. That's not a good or bad thing, but when you say you create a new program, if you don't bring funding, then it's not a new program. It's just a new label. Old wine in new bottles.
Okay.